Milfred spent 2/7 of his pocket money on some food and 2/5 of the remaining pocket money on some stationery. His mother then gave him another $25 and he had $9 more than what he had at first. How much was Milfred's pocket money at first? Okay, nowadays, the remainder concept questions have evolved and it's not that straightforward that you just draw a branching like that and then you find what's left. There is always this intention to make the ending a bit more confusing by adding something like this. Okay, so your solution doesn't end here. You still have to do some manipulation or extra workings to take this last sentence into consideration, then you can find your answer. Yeah, so it's that tricky. So before you can solve this kind of question, you must first know that this is remaining keyword, and remaining keyword tells you that it's remainder concept, and there are two methods, and one is branching and one is pull down method. In this case, because the fractions are very clear, I prefer to use pull down, and normally when there's some intention to confuse you with the ending of the story, I like to use numerator so that I can somehow do something, do my magic to relate it back and then to solve the question. Yeah. If your child is not very sure in how to use branching, please go back to your problem sums guide volume 1 and turn to page 21, and then you follow this. And something that probably is not taught normally is using the final fraction and normally most children have no idea that this exists and they do not know how to find the final fraction. So one trick is to know that this is times, or the branch, actually for every branch it means times. So to find the final fraction, you just need to take 2/3 times 3/5 like this, and then 2/3 times 3/5 like this. So going back to this, to find the final fraction, you take 5/7 times 2/5. There's no need to find this because I didn't use it, but I have to find the final fraction by taking 5/7 times 3/5, which is 15/35. Okay? So in this case, his mother then gave him another $25 and he had $9 more than what he had at first. So we need to relate this to this. This tells me that there are 35 units at first, and after the changes, he only have 15 units left. Okay, so let me zoom out. So in this case, 15 units plus $25, because you just continue from the story. What is left, 15 units plus $25, you have, which is, and this model is $9 more than what he had at first. So 35 units at first, so you draw from here to here, and $9 at first. So looking at this model, you can see that this is $9, and whatever you have here from 15 units to this line is 25 minus of 9, which is $16. From here to here is 16, and then looking at the units from here to here is 35 units minus of 15 units, which is 20 units. So again, the rest is just math to take 16 divided by 20 to find a value of 1 U, which is 80 cents. And they are asking how much was Milfred's pocket money at first. You just need to know that 35 units come from here. So since you have found the value of 1 U, you times 35 to get the answer.